Right, good afternoon everybody. So, rotation of shapes to get one edge of the shape either vertical, horizontal, or at 45 degrees, or parallel to any other line you've drawn. So, what I'm going to show you here today is a new function that I've learned because I was doing some designing and I was scratching my head how to do it, and I eventually read the documentation in Lightburn and I found this new function. So I'm going to draw a line from the point that I want to rotate. So I'm left mouse, but you can see when I hover over and it's going to snap to an intersection, you see the mouse pointer changing. So I'm left clicking, holding shift, dragging out the mouse because we want to do something horizontal in this case. Left clicking, letting go of the mouse, right clicking. So now I've got a horizontal line that I want to rotate this one so it's horizontal to that one. So click the shape, selection tool, click the shape. Make sure your selection mode is in the middle. Then go to arrange, 2-point rotate. Click on the end of the line you've just drawn. Then click and hold on the end of the line you want to change the angle. You can now see I'm playing with it. I'm dragging with the mouse button depressed, clicking onto the end of the line, letting go. And you can see that those two lines are dead over one another. Now, what you have to remember is with the selection tool still selected, to select the line and delete it because you want to get that away from your design. Now you can drag this part around knowing that that line in your design is going to be horizontal. So if you wanted to match up with a square, that you can now you now know that in your design that and that line is parallel. So that's that shape, and then you start playing with it and you can change it back by doing Control Z and it will go back. But let's say that you've saved it in a move position, it's not going to allow you to Control Z to get it back get this back horizontal. So to click, shift, drag out, left click, release the shift, right click. So now we've got the horizontal line. So we want to move this rectangle to get this edge parallel with that line. So now we selection tool, click on the shape. Make sure selection is in the middle and go to arrange, 2-point, click on the intersection of your shape and the line you've drawn by left clicking, moving down here, left clicking and holding. Then I'm sliding the mouse to find the end of the line I've drawn, letting go, and that's done. So, and remember then to delete the line. So that's the way to get your shapes back to an angle that you want. So let's just say you've got that angle. Oh, so let's just say you want to change it to that angle. Now, not sure what angle that line is, but we want to get this shape twisted so it's parallel to that line. We're going to do exactly the same thing. We're going to click on the shape, make sure we're in the middle, arrange, 2-point, click on the intersection, click on the end of the line you want to change, left click in, move the mouse so it's now going to snap on there, let go, job done. Remember then to delete the line. And that's how you rotate lines to an angle that you want. And another way that I found, while we're just talking about angles and lines, if you do a line like that, then you click on it. If you want to get that line back vertical, again, don't try doing this because you'll be there all day. That line is there. So what Lightburn knows is got a start point here and an end point there. And you can see that this is telling you the difference between that point and that point being 50, in our case, 51.92 millimeters. So if you just go making sure the padlock is off and we're in center rotation, go in there, make it zero, and you get a vertical line. So if you want to make the line horizontal, if you go down to the height, because that's measuring the distance between here and here in a vertical direction. So if you make that zero, you get a horizontal line. It's amazing. Lightburn is a massive program, and the more you use it, the more you understand. So that's Andy, as ever, wishing you a very good afternoon and continue making some happy smoke, and I will catch you in the next one. Thanks for making it to the end of my videos. If I've earned your respect and your trust, perhaps you would consider subscribing to my channel. It really does make a massive difference. And maybe you would like to watch some of the videos popping up on the screen now. Let me know what you think. Cheers for now.